knows the Holy Spirit here? Who knows the Holy Spirit? If I hear who is the Holy Ghost now, most of us, we talk about him, but we don't know him. If you ask Abraham, who is God? He will tell you, God is El Shaddai. You know why? He has experienced the supplier of all the needs of humanity. So he's not defining God. He's telling you an experience. Are you with me now? If you ask Moses, who is God? He will tell you, God is the I am that I am. The one that is ever present, that has authority over creation. He's not trying to tell you about God. He's relating to you an experience. They don't define a spirit. They communicate his reality. So Abraham knew the El Shaddai, because it was the El Shaddai that gave a child to a barren woman. It was the El Shaddai that gave a child to an impotent man. It was the El Shaddai that made a man that had nothing to become rich in gold, in cattle, and in silver. So when he said God is El Shaddai, he's telling you about the experience, his intimacy with the Spirit. Moses will tell you, God is I am that I am. The one that caused the waters to come out of the rock. The one that can enter into a land. People who were in captivity for 400 years, only by his words, the nation is bound and they come out in victory. He is communicating an experience. When I ask you, who is the Holy Spirit? If you begin to give me a theological answer, it's because you don't know him. You don't know him. The Holy Ghost is not a theological document. It's not a doctrine. It's not a doctrine. It's a person. It's a person. He has a will. He has emotion. He has a mind. He's the third person on the God of the Godhead. And your experience of him is the only thing you can talk about him. Because God is beyond, is past finding out. You can't talk about his reality. The dimension of him you have experienced is what you can communicate. And when you communicate him, his reality will be trafficked. Who is the Holy Spirit? I came to ask you that question tonight. Who is the Holy Ghost? Who is the Holy Ghost? To some, he is the dimension of the wisdom of God. God spoke concerning Bezalel and Oholiab. In Exodus 33 verse 1 to 3, he said, I have put upon him the spirit of wisdom. And he is going to be skilled in every work of craftsmanship. So for Bezalel and Oholiab, the Holy Spirit is the spirit of wisdom. Because his life is a revelation of the wisdom of God. The things that God showed Moses on the mount, the guy was not there. But through the wisdom of the Holy Spirit, he was able to create that thing. And it was exactly like what was shown Moses in the mount. The Holy Spirit in the life of Bezalel was a wisdom of God. That temple that he built, the presence of God could descend on it any day, any time. It became the tabernacle of the congregation. Every time God wants to appear in the visible realm, that thing that Bezalel built became a doorway to heaven. Many years later, the dimensions that young man trapped, many years later, when the message of Jesus was to be brought to this world, it was in that same temple that the angel Gabriel appeared. That guy, through the wisdom of God, he was able to create a gate from heaven to earth. He was able to bridge the natural realm with the supernatural realm through an infrastructure in the physical world. How was he able to enter into that kind of wisdom that he could build something on earth that could host the dimensions of heaven? He knew the Spirit of God. For him, the Spirit of God is the Spirit of wisdom. When you ask Moses, who is the Holy Ghost? He will tell you, he is power. He is power. People are in captivity for 430 years. He speaks by the Spirit. And the king that was the ruler of all the world, could not dare challenge him. That was the same temple that Moses ran away from as a coward. But he contacted the Spirit. By the backside of the mountain, the Bible said in Horeb, he saw the Spirit of God. And when he returned to the palace where he ran from, the nation bowed at his feet. The Bible said in Exodus chapter 7 verse 1, he said, I have made you a god unto Pharaoh. By what means will a subject of a king become a god? Because he saw his Spirit. When
when it was written about Moses in the book,
the Bible said because he saw him, that was invisible.
The guy who ran away from a king, he returned to that same nation,
and the king bowed.
The nation bowed. How can one man become bigger than a nation?
Because he saw a spirit. Who is the Holy Ghost? You ask Daniel, who is the Holy Ghost? He will call him the excellent spirit.
Spirit of wisdom. Daniel could travel into the dream of a king at night. He was not there when the king dreamt, but he knew a spirit. He said there is a God that revealed secrets. For Daniel, the spirit of God was the spirit of an excellent being. He knew how to enter into heaven. Daniel knew how to travel into the chambers of your heart and tell you the things that God told you in your hiding place. If Daniel came to your school, he doesn't need to attend your lectures. If he entered the exam hall, by the excellent spirit, he can write the marking scheme that the teacher wrote the day before. Even the marking scheme that the teacher wrote many years, Daniel can come and write that marking scheme by an excellent spirit. For him, the Holy Ghost is an excellent spirit. That's how spirits are defined. We don't define spirit by intelligence, because they are bigger than our minds. The dimensions of God cannot be trapped in the mind of a man. Ask Paul, who is the Holy Ghost? Paul will tell you the Holy Ghost is the spirit of mystery. It was Paul that said, we are not just servants. He said, we are the stewards of the mysteries of God. It was Paul that revealed. He said, this is the mystery that was sealed for all ages. Christ in you, the hope of glory. How did Paul know that it was possible for God to dwell in a mortal vessel? He saw his spirit. He saw his spirit. And by that spirit, he entered into a realm of intelligence that the greatest school of thought in his days could not challenge him. Paul could stand, and when he speak, the wisest of men in his generation. Kings in those days were trained by rabbis. Kings were trained by astrologers. Kings were trained by witches and sorcerers. A king could look at a star and tell you, tomorrow it will not rain, because he is cooled by his spirit. They were the wisest men in their days. Paul stood before two kings, and when he spoke, they say, your knowledge, too much knowledge, have made you mad. The kings could not understand. How does this man speak? How do you speak like this? Who taught you this thing? He knew his spirit. Who is the Holy Ghost? You think it's about gathering scriptures. The scriptures you gathered and crammed from your concordance, you use it to define the spirit. You cannot define the spirit on the strength of your intelligence. You need to find out how the patriarchs engaged him. How did they know this being who is so wise? How did they come in contact with this God who is invisible, dwelling in the realms of Zion? How is it possible for man living on earth to travel into the regions of the heavens? How is it possible for man to download the mind of God? The mind of God, a man who walk into heaven, and he will speak, he will say, concerning virgins, God has not spoken to me, but as a man who is faithful, I have been counted worthy. Whatever I say is the mind of God. You don't need to consult with God. If I speak, go to heaven. That is the same thing God will be saying. How did men know how to enter heaven? They could download the things happening in heaven. There were some of them, if they stood now and they tell you now heaven is quiet, you don't need to argue. If you travel, heaven will be quiet. Why? Because they knew the Holy Ghost. The way of the patriarchs. They were men of the spirit. How could a man venture place a name on God? God has no name. Nobody had introduced him before. And suddenly Abraham shows up and he says his name is the El Shaddai. How dare you name a God? You don't give him a name. He has no name. He created all things. The dimensions of the earth, they came out of his prowess. He spake and heaven appeared. He spake, the waters appeared. He spake, the land appeared. How dare you give a name to him? Are you going to call that kind of person a name? But Abraham did. He said he's called the El Shaddai, because he saw his spirit. He saw his spirit in the heavens. He saw his spirit. Who is the Holy Ghost? We have young people priding themselves, talking things that they have no understanding about. You don't know the Holy Ghost. And until our generation is taught who the Holy Ghost is, there is no revival.
There will be no hope for the next generation. Why do you think Islam is advancing so much? These guys are not theologians. They only know how to engage a spirit. And that spirit shocks them up. He eats their soul. You will see a young boy of 12 years. He will die for God. And all he will say is, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. He doesn't care what his life is. He has seen a spirit. And that spirit has eaten up his soul. Kill him, it doesn't count. Kill his father, it doesn't count. All he needs to do is, Allahu Akbar. Who is the Holy Ghost to you? You are living for your appetites. Running about from bowl to toast. You don't know what life is about. You don't know the Holy Ghost. You have not begun to live, my brother, unless you know the Spirit. Unless you know the Spirit. I didn't come to define the Holy Ghost to you. I know him as the God of mercy. Because when I check my life, I don't deserve anything. He stretched his hand and he picked me from an obscure society. I was a man wandering about in confusion. I didn't know my left from my right. I had nobody to help me. I graduated from the university. There was no hope. But a spirit appeared to me. And he said, I will make you an apostle to the nations. I know him as the God of mercy. So every time I stand, I say, Lord, show mercy. Show mercy. For me, the Holy Ghost is the God of mercy. I don't know him. I don't know what you call him. Moses called him the God of power. Abraham called him the El Shaddai. Daniel called him the excellent spirit. I don't know what you call him. I don't know what you call him. But Paul called him the God of mystery. Paul called him the God of mystery. Peter called him the God of power. What do you call him? John called him the God of revelation. And on the strength of that revelation, they casted him to the eyes of Patmos. They wanted him to die there. Even in Patmos, the guy said, I was in the spirit on the Lord's day. I was in the spirit on the Lord's day. I was in the spirit in Patmos. Patmos was supposed to be his grave. That was the ground where he was supposed to be buried. But from Patmos, he traveled to heaven. He entered the corridors of Zion. John was carried around in a car through heaven. He knew the whole dimensions of heaven because he knew a God that was a God of revelation. Who is the Holy Ghost to you? I am kata kata kata. My friend Reverend Hughes, a man who was in the university, he had 17 carryovers and he was withdrawn from his first degree, but a spirit appeared to him and he said, I am Jehovah Academia. And from there the guy went and made a first class degree. He didn't stop there. He became the overall best graduate student in the university. Why? The failure, he saw Jehovah Academia, and suddenly his mental power was accelerated. Suddenly his mental inefficacies were strengthened. Suddenly his weaknesses became his strength. The very land where he was subdued, he came back there and he was coronated as a prince because he saw a spirit. He saw a spirit. He saw a spirit. You want to see a spirit tonight? Ask the Lord for an encounter. Ask the Lord for an encounter. Weakness. If only you will see the Holy Ghost, it will become the area of strength. Some of you are slaves of sin. If only you will see him, it will become the spirit of righteousness. If you will see him, it will become God your healer. Your sicknesses can vanish. Your pains can go away. Your sins can be lost. You can become an apostle. You can become a politician. And many years from now, the generations to come will look at you and they will call you blessed. Because you become one of the patriarchs that will define the philosophies in their lives. You will become one of the patriarchs that will define their ideologies, the systems of the world to come. You could be the one to pioneer it. Moses wrote the laws, and the whole civilizations of the world, they are anchored on the laws of Moses. He is the patriarch that defines civilization. Come on!